हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल शॉर्ट एंड क्लासेस विद रेनू। स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम कैलाश चंद्रा का वॉल्यूम 24 और ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 510 करेंगे। 60 वर्ड पर मिनट स्टार्ट। मिस्टर डिप्टी चेयरमैन, सर, दिस डिस्कशन हैज कम एट एन एप्रोप्रिएट टाइम when people in this country are very much concerned about the future of the press, its structure and its freedom, and therefore I welcome this opportunity to say a few words. I think that there is a good deal of misunderstanding, rivalry and tension between the parliament and the press, and this misunderstanding exists on both sides of the house. The usual attitude among the politicians is that if a newspaper supports their party, then it is independent, and if it criticizes their party, then it is the mouthpiece of the monopolists. Well, sir, it is not as simple as that. We all know that many parties, when they have been in power, for instance, the DMK, the CPM, all these parties have harassed newspapers when they have been in power. Sir, this is not a situation that is new to India. It exists in all democratic countries. To some extent, it is inevitable, and we have to learn to live with it. The tension and the rivalry arise mostly because some of the functions of the press and the parliament overlap. Also because the two institutions, to a great extent, depend on each other, and this results in a certain amount of resentment. There is also the fact that the press has a function to be a critic of the government, a watchdog of the government as well as of the political parties, and this is often misunderstood as hostility. But in our situation today, where we are still building a democracy, where democratic institutions have to be built up and sustained, and where our freedom has to be maintained, I think it is essential to create rather more cooperation and understanding between the press and the parliament. I believe, sir, that one of the important functions of the press council could be and should be to act as a link between the parliament and the government on the one hand, and the press and the public on the other. I feel that some of the misunderstandings that have developed since independence between the press and the government are due to certain historical reasons. Before independence, the national newspapers existed for the national movement. There was no conflict between the two. The proprietors, the एडिटर्स एंड द लीडर्स ऑफ आवर नेशनल मूवमेंट वर यूनाइटेड फॉर द सिंगल एम ऑफ रिमूविंग द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट।